Sophie was in the fourth grade, and she had to do a project about people in history or people they admire. And she picked me. So Sophie went through her mom's email account and emailed me her questions for her class project. And then it became just kind of this back and forth email exchange because Sophie had my email and I would email back because it was a really awesome break in the day. I mean, a reporter's inbox is filled with story ideas or correspondence about a story, and sometimes new stories are not pleasant. So when one would pop in my window from Sophie, I knew it was going to be completely different. I went to CrossFit today. Have you ever gone down a water slide? I did. And she would tell me about the Wisconsin Dells or deadlifting as a little kid, or my softball team's pretty good. You should come to a game sometime.
Well, when I looked at my desk, I actually found a lot. I have a chance to get into schools all the time and talk to kids, and kids are so sweet when they write you. And I love the fact that this is just a lost art, but here's one. You are the best, you are kind, you are amazing, and I love you. Thank you for a wonderful life. As I was looking through all the letters of the kids, I actually found this postcard that I've held on to as I'm looking at the date. 20 years, it was from the year 2000. Right after Christmas, I met this gal at the Toys for Tots tent, and she really needed to have toys for her kids, and it was her first year that she ever needed help, and she really appreciated it. So she wanted to come by and give what she could, and then she was going to receive toys down the road to give to her kids. And then she said, thank you so much for talking to me at the tent. I've never been in this position before, and I so appreciate Care 11 and all that you do. So it was really an awesome postcard. Obviously, it meant a lot to me because I held on to it for a long time, 20 years.
I do get handwritten letters occasionally. They're usually from younger kids, if I've visited their class or they are interested in journalism, or they're from an older generation, our older viewers. They're always special and meaningful, though, because they are pretty rare. As everybody else reaches out on Facebook or email, which is also great, but there is something special about seeing someone's handwriting and knowing that they took the time to write it out themselves, put a stamp on it, get it in the mail. And frankly, it's easier to access. I've got some emails that I've kept because people have been so kind or encouraging, and I just think, you know, I really should keep that. But then I can't find it. Either I should be more organized or print it off or something. Because sometimes, you know, we all have bad days, and it's great to get those letters that are encouraging.
So I got this letter from a high school gal from St. Michael, Minnesota, about last week. And it's 4 pages. And when I read it, I was floored. I was almost in tears by the end of the letter. She wrote me because she said I gave her something special, and that was courage. She goes to a high school in St. Michael where she said it had been previously known for a lot of racist ideas and ideology. She wrote me and said, I saw you on TV and I see the things that you stand for, and I follow you on social media, and I really, really just wanted to write you this letter. So I'm gonna read one passage from the end that just really got at my heart. I hope you get this letter. I want more people to know. I will keep sending you letters and messages if this does not work out. I'm going to keep trying. You taught me not to give up. If you're reading this, thank you. And I want her to know that, yeah, I got your letter. I got your messages. I think it's so special when there are people out in our communities who feel such a connection to us. These are really special.